Hello guys, welcome back to the new video. This is Mission Control Houston. Now at our and 15 minutes into today's planned 7-hour spacewalk to replace a failed pump unit as part of the cooling system on the exterior of the International Space Station. Tracy Caldwell Dyson and Doug Bilog moving along and doing a good job of keeping on the timeline for their task, both of them working at the S1 area of the truss structure as they prepare to remove the failed pump module from the cooling system. Again, all this work is ongoing now because of a failure that occurred last Saturday of the pump module that is used to circulate ammonia through the huge radiators they are used to get rid of excess heat generated by the electronic components on board the International Space Station. Crew successfully installed several jumpers that allowed for the best possible redundancy of station systems. And some of the external systems on the station are cooled by only one of the two redundant cooling loops, A and B, of this ammonia system. Again, the ammonia is used on the outside of the station to reject the excess heat, and a heat exchanger allows it to take the excess heat from the water-based cooling system on the inside of the station. Throughout this week, flight controllers on the ground work to develop procedures for this pump removal and replacement. The conditions inside the station have been pretty much normal for the International Space Station crew. Thanks to some work they did immediately after the failure to configure those jumpers so that the best possible system configuration could be working. The biggest change to the crew has been that they have refocused their attention from the scientific investigations inside of the station onto preparations for the spacewalk. They had been already scheduled to conduct a spacewalk on Thursday, but it was for a completely different purpose. Those tasks have been put off until we can complete this more critical removal and replacement of the pump module. This is Mission Control Houston, Oscar Keller, the Intervehicular Activity Support Officer here in Mission Control ready, and going up to Doug Willock that the EVA folks here on the ground are seeing that these quick disconnect wires on the ammonia lines that he is going to be removing are not lining up. You can see the center line there is M2. It has a white area that is exposed that shows that the bale is in the full open position on the two outside lines, the M1 and the M3. We are not seeing that white line, and so Willock is being offered the opportunity to check that and make sure that those are in the full open position. He is got a special tool he is pulling out of his tool bag right now that he can use to get some additional leverage if he needs to make that setup properly connected up so that he is ready to go with removing those ammonia lines. They want to make sure that they are completely open so that they are disconnected, and that is expected to help minimize the release of any ammonia which we don't want contaminating the spacewalk or spacesuits. We are talking about, do we want you to push the button or not push the button where you can try to move the bale? Okay, pull it forward, press the button and move the bale out. Okay, Oscar, it is hung up again where I got a full white band, but the button is stuck down. It is not extended, so I guess you try to open it again. Yeah, okay, and stand by Wills. Wills, if you want, we think the scoop may give you a little better hammer. You have a go to attempt with the scoop on the button. Okay, and Wills, if you want to pull and try to tap at the same time, that is okay. Roger that. I got a hand on it, but I can't see what you are doing, so I am fine. Okay, it is full forward, Oscar. Awesome, push that button down. Okay, let me get that lever tool. Don't snap back again. Don't kick back, it is okay. There is a big round of applause down here, and it will fall. Yeah, we got it. Here we go. And so at 12:20 p.m. Central Time, Doug Willock, using a scoop tool to bang on the detention button on that big connector, he succeeded in closing the valve so that he can make final preparations to demate that device. We are still standing by to hear whether or not that is what they want to do here in Mission Control. But applause in the control room as he was able to get the bale open and get the quick disconnect ready to go. That was a little sporty right there. This is Mission Control Houston, now 6 hours 26 minutes into today's spacewalk by Doug Willock and Tracy Caldwell Dyson. The team on the ground has worked with the crew to put this final connector that has been back throughout the spacewalk into a space configuration. They have reinstalled it onto its connection on the pump module and installed a spool positioning device. That is a device that is added to these quick disconnects to allow them to function optimally. These devices have been installed around the station on the fluid lines in many different locations. There have been evidence of some leakage of the ammonia from within the system, and that has clearly come in contact with the spacewalkers in several different times during the spacewalk. Just to qualify that ammonia is a hazardous substance, but this is by no means the first time spacewalkers have come into contact with ammonia outside the space station. There is a standard procedure for inspection of each of the two spacewalkers' space suits to look for any visible evidence of ammonia that might be clinging to their space suits. And they will have a specific period of time in which they will basically bake out in the vacuum of space so that any residual ammonia can sublimate and leave their spacesuit before they come back inside the airlock. Anytime an astronaut gets out of a vehicle while in space, it is called a spacewalk. A spacewalk is also called an EVA. EVA stands for extravehicular activity. The first person to go on a spacewalk was Alexei Leonov. He was from Russia. The first spacewalk was on March 18, 1965. It was 10 minutes long. The first American to go on a spacewalk was Ed White. His spacewalk was on June 3, 1965. During the Gemini 4 mission, White's spacewalk lasted 23 minutes. Today, astronauts go on spacewalks outside the International Space Station. Spacewalks usually last between 5 and 8 hours depending on the job. The world record for the most spacewalk is held by Russian astronaut Anatoly. He has been on 16 spacewalks. Those spacewalks equal more than 82 hours outside in space. That is almost 3.5 days total. The US record for most spacewalks is a four-way tie. Four NASA astronauts have made 10 spacewalks each. They are Michael Lopez Alegria, Peggy Whitson, Bob Behnken, and Chris Cassidy. Of the four, Michael spent the most time outside the space station. His total is more than 67 hours. Astronauts go on spacewalks for many reasons. Spacewalks let astronauts work outside their spacecraft while still in space. Astronauts can do science experiments on a spacewalk. Experiments can be placed on the outside of a spacecraft. This lets scientists learn how being in a space affects different things. Spacewalks also let astronauts test new equipment. They can repair satellites or spacecraft that are in space. By going on spacewalks, astronauts can fix things instead of bringing them back to Earth to fix. When astronauts go on spacewalks, they wear spacesuits to keep themselves safe. Inside spacesuits, astronauts have the oxygen they need to breathe. They have the water they need to drink. Astronauts put on their spacesuits several hours before a spacewalk. The suits are pressurized. This means that the suits are filled with oxygen. Once in their suits, astronauts breathe pure oxygen for a few hours. Breathing only oxygen gets rid of all the nitrogen in an astronaut's body. If they didn't get rid of the nitrogen, the astronauts might get gas bubbles in their body when they walked in space. These gas bubbles can cause astronauts to feel pain in their shoulders, elbows, wrists, and knees. This pain is called getting the bends because it affects the places where the body bends. Scuba divers can also get the bends. Astronauts are now ready to get out of their spacecraft. They leave the spacecraft through a special door called an airlock. The airlock has two doors. When astronauts are inside the spacecraft, the airlock is airtight so no air can get out. When astronauts get ready to go on a spacewalk, they go through the first door and lock it tight behind them. They can then open the second door without any air getting out of the spacecraft. After a spacewalk, astronauts go back inside through the airlock. When on a spacewalk, astronauts use safety tethers to stay close to their spacecraft. Tethers are like ropes. One end is hooked to the spacewalker, the other end is connected to the vehicle. The safety tethers keep astronauts from floating away into space. Astronauts also use tethers to keep tools from floating away. They tether their tools to the spacesuits. Another way astronauts stay safe during spacewalk is by wearing a SAFR. SAFR stands for Simplified Aid for EVA Rescue. SAFR is worn like a backpack. It uses small jet thrusters to let an astronaut move around in space. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you like the video, then please make sure to like, subscribe, share, and also press the bell icon for more informative videos.